And look, welcome to Brainflow TV again, everybody. It is your host at the most. Now, check this out. Whitney Houston was well known to a lot of people and loved by a lot of people. If not for the sheer fact that she could sing, but for the fact that a lot of us grew up watching her grow up as well. And of course, her tragic ending, leaving behind her daughter, Bobby Christina, right? Stemming from a name from her father, which is Bobby Brown. So pop star Bobby Brown, and you have pop star, rock star, superstar Whitney Houston making this beautiful child who herself died shortly after her mother died. And the boyfriend was heavily involved, and we're going to talk about that because he just turned up dead as well. Check this out. So Nick Gordon was his name, right? And he was the partner of the late Bobby Christina Brown, the only daughter of the late Whitney Houston and singer Bobby Brown. And he is dead at the age of 30, his lawyer said on Wednesday. In an email to the Los Angeles Times, attorney Joe Habachi of Atlanta said that he could not speak to the specifics surrounding the circumstances of Gordon's death, but he did write that it's been truly heartbreaking to have witnessed firsthand the total devastation that drug addiction has wreaked upon the young lives of all these people. People that were loved and had immense potential. That's what he wrote. Anyhow, Gordon himself, a little background on him. He landed in the spotlight after Bobby Christina Brown, which is Whitney Houston's child with Bobby Brown, was found unresponsive on June 31st of 2015. We can never forget that. She was face down in a bathtub of a townhome she shared with Gordon near Atlanta. The sad part about that story was her mother had just died under similar circumstances. Bobby Christina, she was rushed to the hospital and she never regained her consciousness. She was in a coma for quite some time. I believe it was almost 6 months where she was then put into hospice care and then she died. She passed away July 26th of 2015. So after an autopsy on her, they found that several narcotics, to include prescription drugs, were in her body, marijuana, alcohol, and medications that were used for either sedation or used to treat anxiety, which means it would have made her like drowsy, go to sleep beyond her control, that type of stuff, slowed her heart rate, lose consciousness. And the underlying cause of her death was listed as immersion associated with drug intoxication. Bobby Christina Brown, she was only 22 at the time. And she was the sole heir. Get this. She was the sole heir to the Houston's estate. All the stuff that Whitney left behind. She was the sole heir to all of that. So, in a sense, she was a walking target. And this guy knew that. And he weaseled his way right in. But he was put in a position to be able to weasel his way right in. So, on February 11th of 2012... Houston, who reigned as one of the world's top pop stars in the 80s and 90s with songs like I Will Always Love You and Saving All My Love For You, but suffered from recurring bouts with drug and alcohol, Whitney Houston was found dead after accidentally drowning in a Beverly Hills hotel room bathtub the night before the Grammy Awards. Now, listen, I don't buy that story. And I know majority of you who are listening to this don't buy that damn story. We remember Whitney Houston's sister-in-law, that Bobby's sister, who came up and said that she traveled a lot with Whitney and Whitney would never get in a hotel bathtub. She would take the shower. She would use the showers there. But she has never in all her years gotten in a hotel bathtub. And it's because she always thought that there were germs in those bathtubs and she didn't want to go lay in one. She didn't care where it was or how fancy the hotel was. So it was strange to her, such a close friend of Whitney, to actually see her or found out that she drowned in a bathtub. And mind you, she was a very good swimmer. So drowning in a bathtub was, it was just a bunch of, suspicious circumstances surrounding the death of Whitney Houston. And of course, the same thing happened later on with her daughter. Same exact thing. In a bathtub, face down, drowned. The coroner said that Whitney's use of cocaine exacerbated her heart disease and played a role in her death. I don't know. At the time of her death, it was said that she was hooked heavily on cocaine, and they blamed Bobby Brown for it and all that other stuff. Now, of course, as far as her daughter goes, a multi-million dollar civil suit was filed by the conservator of Bobby Christina Brown's estate, right? Alleged that Gordon had physically abused Bobby Christina Brown. So the boy who is dead now, or the young man who's dead now, had physically abused Whitney Houston's daughter, including knocking out her teeth. That's how much he was beating her. Knocked her teeth out. Not a tooth. Her teeth. Knocked out her front teeth. Dragged her up a whole bunch of steps and had controlled her and had taken a significant amount of money out of her accounts without her permission. I think when Bobby Christina Brown found out all this, and then she was estranged from her father, which is Bobby Brown, and she had just lost her mom, which is Whitney Houston, I think she was just spiraling into a world of darkness. And of course, having someone who she thought she could have trusted and she thought loved her, right, beating on her, abusing her, and using her, and she realized what it was. I think she felt trapped and felt like she had nowhere to turn, no one to turn to. So she was under the whole, I'm going to get as high as possible. And I think he took advantage of that, and he mixed a fatal cocktail for her, which actually ended up taking her life. I don't think he tried to kill her. I think he wanted to keep her in a sedative state where he was able to go and come as he pleased, go into her account, take out however much money he pleased, and whatever he needed, so on and so forth. But this fatal cocktail ended up killing her. So it's alleged that Gordon had maneuvered himself into a boyfriend role and then fraudulently represented himself as Bobby Christina Brown's husband to access the multi-million dollar estates that she had inherited. Now, I don't know if you remember, but at one point he was living at the house when she was below the age of consent. And it was said that he was Whitney Houston's adopted son. So he was looked at as Bobby Christina's brother. So a lot of us were not buying that story. We just thought that Whitney was letting her daughter, teenage daughter, do as she pleased, to include living with a man at her age. And then when she became old enough, he came out and said he was her boyfriend. Anyways, later on saying that he was her husband. So the suit that they filed against him was later amended to allege that Gordon, who is dead now, gave Bobby Christina, which is Whitney Houston's daughter, a toxic cocktail, rendering her unconscious, and then put her face down in the bathtub of cold water, causing her to suffer brain damage. So in other words, his defense was probably that they found her that way and he was trying to revive her. But they determined later on from autopsy that she was placed in that position, and more than likely, he put her in there face down in the water to look as if she had drowned when in fact she had overdosed, right? So while she OD'd and she was unconscious and then placing her face down in the water, she drowned, because being unconscious and not being able to get up out of the water, she simply ingested a whole bunch of water and she got brain damaged, then went to a coma, and then from the coma to death. In 2016, a judge in Atlanta had actually ruled that Gordon was liable for Brown's death. The judge said that because he repeatedly failed to meet court deadlines in the case, the conservator of Brown's estate had won by default. And I believe it was like $32 to $36 million that he was awarded to pay towards her estate. So here she was with all of Whitney Houston's millions and plus now $30+ million was to be paid towards her estate. Sadly, she did not have a chick or a child to pass that on to, right? So in November of 2016, the judge ordered Gordon to pay more than $36 million in damages. No criminal charges were filed against him. And this is where a lot of people were saying, yo, that was murder. He simply murdered that girl. You know what I'm saying? He got her high as hell. He placed her face down when she went unconscious in a bathtub full of water, and she freaking drowned. That was murder. But again, nothing came of it. He was officially adopted at 12 years old by Whitney Houston, and he was raised as the brother to Bobby Christina. That is why a lot of us found it really funny when he and her became an item. Now, he was raised, he was adopted at 12 by her, and then they became romantically involved. This is crazy. Right around the time when Whitney Houston was passing or passed away. And he was not allowed to attend Bobby Christina Brown's funeral for the burial. And I know her dad probably would have took his head off his body talking about Bobby Brown had he showed up. So Gordon did a stint in rehab in March of 2015 after behaving erratically on an episode of Dr. Phil, where he was to have talked about Bobby Christina Brown's death. And a lot of people are saying, yep, that's what you call karma. That's what you call a guilty conscience. And he was sedating himself with drugs to deal with what the hell it is that he had done to that young girl. So that April, he sat down again with Phil McGraw, laughed off the civil case and dollar amount that it sought, and dismissed the notion that he had given his girlfriend a toxic cocktail. So they're saying to him, like, yo, you got found guilty in a civil suit and you got to pay back over $36 million to her estate. And he was laughing it off, right? Think about how far-fetched that ludicrous that sound is what he actually had said to McGraw. That's just stupid. In the statement, Gordon's lawyer, Hibachi, said that despite all of the challenges Gordon faced in recent years, that he worked hard to hold his head up and to stay sober, and he genuinely wanted a happy, healthy life with his family more than anything else. My heart goes out to the family and friends of Nick as he leaves them behind, and other family members dealing with the losses and heartaches caused by drugs. Now, let me end this video by saying this. I've been looking at the comments on a couple of these sites, and there is not much sympathy out there for Nick Gordon, simply because Bobby Christina, again, was a darling. She was the baby and the only child of Whitney Houston. And Whitney Houston's baby girl, we got to watch her grow up. And then we watched her die shortly after her mom died at the young, tender age of 22 years old. So in our eyes, he murdered her. And he got away with the murder. And now this is karma that has come back to get him. I'll leave it at that. Leave your comments in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about this one. Do you think that he actually had something to do with the death of Bobby Christina? I mean, he was found guilty in a civil court, but no criminal charges were filed against him. And do you think that this was just straight up karma? Talk it up. I'm out. Peace.